Hai, we are Glaucus Atlanticus Team
from Banyu Pramanta ITS Surabaya, Indonesia.
Since 2018 until now, we have a lot of experience in the robotic field. In 2019, we volunteered as technical assistant for the Asian Meet ROV, then we got the top 10 remotely operated underwater vehicle at Teknojin Telkom University. We also got special awards at First Batu Robotic Competition. In 2020, we have been shortlisted from 90 teams, became 41 teams, consists of 19 countries for Singapore AUV Challenge. And we also got first champion remotely operated underwater vehicle at Teknojin Telkom University.
In this competition, we participated in the ROV Challenge category. There are two problems with our robot when carrying out the mission that has been made by WIRC. The first one is ROV floats on the surface of the water, so the method we use is the addition of a ballast, and for the result is the ROV can float underwater. The second problem was that the pump couldn't start because the motor shaft was corroded, so the method we use is to clean up the pump motor shaft with a greaser, then the result is the pump can function properly. The conclusion is that although there were some problems when making the robot, solutions could be found immediately so that now the robot can run properly to pick up the marbles within at least 25 seconds for each marble.
The challenge of the mission given by WIRC is to pick up as many objects as possible. In this case, we are using marbles from the cargo area in the middle of the tank and drop them into the basket area without hitting the window. So we broke this challenge down into 4-minute tasks based on our divisions: mechanical, electrical, programming, and official. From official, we complete all the documents required by the team and make the final presentation video.
We have to design the robots using Inventor software according to the rules.
Designing a pump to pick up marbles from cargo hold to basket area, manufacturing the robots.
From electrical, we have to design PCB design, make a wiring diagram, and soldering.
We have to make a program on the remote control and the robot.
There are several main materials that needed to build our robots. We will divide it into three parts. First, we design the 3D body of our robots with Autodesk Inventor, and then we start to manufacture the robot. We use watertight launch box as the main body because the launch box has a seal that can lock the flow of air and water out of the box. The frame used is made of filaments and formed using 3D print. The consideration in choosing this type of frame are the flexibility of the design and the ease of installing the boat system to apply this DC motor reusable strategy to the robot. The battery is installed at an angle as it follows for a compact design and prioritize dimensional efficiency in the robot. Next is propeller, which is used to move the fluid to the desired place so that a thrust force is generated due to the collision of the fluid particles, in this case is water. The use of a pump modified with PVC pipe makes it easier for the robot to suck up the marbles. In addition, it is also modified using a hose that is curved and pointed upward to minimize the linear momentum of the fluid in the culvert system and also to provide a downward force for the marble vacuum when it is about to take the marble.
In the electronic part, we use Autodesk Eagle to make the design of PCB electronic and Proteus as prototyping voltage regulator circuit. Some electrical component that we use in our robot are Arduino Nano that will be used as an embedded system for a robot microcontroller. Next, we use motor driver TB6612FNG as motor driver by adjusting the rotation speed of the motor that is connected directly to the Arduino Nano PWM pin. LM7805 is also used as voltage regulator to reduce the voltage from 12V to 5V, which will be used to supply the Arduino voltage and the motor driver. Then we use battery LiPo 3-cell 1500 mAh. This battery is small, so it fits perfectly in the lock and lock. And this battery is sufficient for all harness to be used in the race. And also, we use remote and receiver FastKey FSI66 channel as a robot controller. And we use C language as the programming language to program the embedded system.
The process starts from the operator who gives instruction via the remote control. And then the receiver from the remote control will receive the instruction and send it to the motor. so that the robot can move according to the instruction given. We have planned and coded our robot and remote control, but something happened to our robot. We analyzed there are a few issues that occur with our robot. First, PWM on the motor cannot work because inaccuracy in programming. So we create a little write program, not an arc write. Second, about remote sensitivity because misread the sensitivity value. So we recheck the analog on the remote. It moves like whether the motor will move full of power or not moving by using the serial monitor in the program to find out the coordinate or sensitivity on the analog remote control. Third, the pin configuration is wrong, so it doesn't run on the hardware because misinformed from several reference and inaccuracy. So we solve it by double checking the program we made is in accordance with the pins installed in Arduino on the motor.
By doing this mission, we learn and gain lots about manufacturing the robots, especially about make a design system that is protected from leakage, how to integrate two motor drivers with limited digital pins on Arduino Nano, how to solder properly and correctly, cable selection for wiring, selection of battery and electronic components, able to program the ROV, how to remote control process move the ROV. And also, we would like to share this experience to other ROV Challenge participants that it is important to have careful preparation and design.
In the future, to improve our strategy, we want to make it easier for the pilot to operate the ROV. Then, on the next project, it will be added accelerometer sensor as a self-balancing ROV. The sensor to be used is the MPU6050 using the PID concept, so the robot movement will be smoother and close to perfect. Moreover, we provide control features using a GUI via a laptop, which can simplify the trial and error of the ROV.
Banyu Pramanta ITS!
Jelajah Jeladi Jakana Jaya!